Hey everyone, I'm back again with another video, and this one is titled, I Just Found the Pregnancy Test. Please make sure you like the video and subscribe, and don't forget to hit the bell so you don't miss any of my future videos. Let's get right into it. I can't get it out of my head. She hasn't been hiding her affair at all. We're just friends. There's nothing physical. I'm not attracted to him at all. He's not my type. I babysat our kids so she could go see him, thinking she would get tired of it and come back. But it tore me apart. We went to individual counseling with the goal of marriage counseling after a month. She told the counselor the same thing. There is no intercourse, it's all emotions. But she kept seeing him, kept texting him while in bed with me. When I would try to talk to her about our relationship or how her actions made me feel, she would blow up or have an anxiety attack, like she couldn't emotionally handle a simple conversation about us or his effect on our family. I kept finding their messages, and she would get upset that I was looking at them. One week after they met, they told each other, "You are the first and last thing I think about every day." 2 weeks after they met, she was asking him to convince her to feel secure about leaving me. 7 weeks after they met, I found a way into her WhatsApp conversations with him. They were talking about her 6-week scare that she was pregnant. I wanted to keep my access to their chat a secret, but this changed everything. I confronted her. She seemed relieved that I found out, almost happy. But her reaction was to snatch my phone and run off with it, stating that I can see her stuff. She can see mine too. Then she left me, with our kids, boys 4 and 8, while I was sick with COVID symptoms, and we were supposed to be staying inside pending results, to run off with him. She came back after 9 hours. The next day, results came back negative, and I felt well enough to leave. I felt used, providing her financial stability while she devoted all of her time, energy, and emotions into him, while draining our marriage of the same. I mostly stayed at work. I have a great aunt in the area, but she's older and her husband passed away a few years ago. I presented her the flag during his funeral. She is lonely and wants someone to talk to, but I want to be left alone. It wouldn't work for my situation. One night, I had the gut feeling I needed to drive down by the house. Don't stop, just make a loop, I told myself. We live at the end of a cul-de-sac, and I have a bright orange vehicle, so once I got so far, I'm committed to drive all the way down. I pulled up and stopped across from our apartment. He pulled up at the same time as me. For a few days after I felt free, I was ready to take the next step, so I called a lawyer. I wanted to file for divorce that week, but in the state I live in, it's a no-fault state in regards to infidelity. We just moved here 3 months ago, and I can't even file for divorce for another 3 months. On top of that, the lawyer told me leaving was the worst thing I could do. I have to show the court co-parenting if I want to win joint custody, at least 3 nights a week with the kids overnight. I'm the one working, leasing 2 vehicles, 51K in debt, 15 years in the military, but married for 8 years. I can't afford another place to live. We are already barely sliding by as it is. So I went back on 8th of October, asking if I could come back, spend more time with the kids, work on our friendship. So here I am, week number 9 of this nightmare. Every moment we spend together, she's on her phone. She tells me she is confused, doesn't know who to choose. She loves 2 men, but loves me only as her husband and as the father of her children. When I'm in the apartment around her, I want to work on us. I hate myself for how much I love her, because I want her to come back. But even right now, I'm home alone. She took our kids to his place to make s'mores together. When she left, I started cleaning the house. That's the only thing I've done since it all started. Clean. and in one of the bathroom trash cans, I found the pregnancy test. I hate her. I love her. I hate myself for loving her. It's the worst feeling. But I have to keep living this nightmare. And the first comment says, never stand by for something like that, where you're watching your SO get closer and closer to someone. Your gut is telling you exactly what it is, and they are acting entitled to it and shutting you down. Your gut is very good about telling you when there is a competing mate in the picture. This is true for both men and women. If you allow an SO to stay in their illusion where they're not doing anything wrong, it's the same as inviting the affair. Sounds like you tried OP, in a very tolerant, loving manner beyond what she actually deserved. You communicated, but she didn't care. You should not be tolerating her behavior. You should be cutting her off from your support. The fact that she's comfortable enough in her lifestyle to openly tell you that she's shopping around for men and deciding between you indicates she believes she's in a very secure position and can use you. Stop the credit cards before she runs you into debt. Try to separate your finances as best you can. Don't give her money. If you pay for her smartphone plan, cancel it now. Buy limited phone service or prepaid to use for parenting. Cancel any other luxury services she uses for herself and or her boyfriend. If she wants to continue cheating, he can pay for those things now. And the second comment says, if you're active duty, call your closest regional legal service office to schedule an appointment with legal assistance. They will know the laws in your state. This will also conflict her out of the system, so she can't get help from them. Keep your eye on the time of your marriage. After 10 years of marriage, she gets half of your retirement unless she waives it. No fault states don't care who did what. Also, some states don't allow you to record conversations without the consent of the other person. Don't confront the other guy or get into a fight. You don't need NJP on top of everything else. Don't do anything without talking to a lawyer first, like freezing accounts or selling property. I'm retired military. My spouse of 11 years cheated on me constantly. Divorced in California, and no fault state, I had to buy him out of the home I own because Cali is also a community property state. I bought the house while we married as my sole and separate property, but had a civilian lawyer that said it didn't matter, even though it wasn't in his name. I probably could have fought harder, but at that point, I was just so done. I had to refinance the house to give him cash. The cash was enough for him to move out of my house and go to Texas with his new squeeze and get him to waive the 50% of my retirement. Good luck, stay safe, be smart. Thank you guys for watching. Please comment below and let me know if there's any other subreddits you guys would like me to make videos on, and also like the video and please subscribe.